What is up, everybody? You are now watching Vlogs TV, and I am back with another reaction video. And in today's video, I will be reacting to top 10 most shocking boxing moments slash scandals. Okay, almost died right there. So, hopefully you enjoy the video. The original link will be down in the description below. Let's get into it.
Where's the bell? At this point, it should be over. They should be going back to their corners.
It was a very long round.
The bell was rung.
Secondly, finally, when the bell rang, Elijah Tillery stuck his face out.
Hey, kicking?
But he both just hit it. And you see Rock Newman getting involved in this.
Oh, what?
Almost falling over the ropes.
The fight when Bear unmasked the man called the Ambling Owl as little more than a muddling mediocrity, whose record of 76 wins with 59 KOs was more than somewhat suspect. From the first round on, Bear was able to keep the Man Mountain in front of him at long range, then cross over his bazooka-like right, flush on the soon-to-be ex-champion's jaw.
Wait, so he has 76 wins with 59 knockouts? Yeah, really rough, really rough. You know that man being held up by them ropes. It's old school boxing though, shit.
Going down a total of 11 times. Sometimes even pulling Bear down with him as he tried to hold on to something, anything.
As Carnero went down again, Bear went with him.
Man, getting there.
He was taken down by the fallen Canelo.
Bricks beating off his ass.
Last one
I almost forgot to say it, so that's why I didn't really say it.
With nothing to keep him on his feet but a big heart. A helpless, stumbling Canelo appealed to referee Arthur Donovan to stop the fight in the 11th round.
And that used to, back then, boxing used to go like 15 rounds, so.
Donovan mercifully called a halt to the most one-sided fight ever.
Number 8. Cause that's Holyfield. Oh yeah, oh that big ass, swollen ass knot. That shit big.
What is the danger of that? George, can you tell?
Yeah, I think maybe he had got cracked skull. You know, you got bones up there. Sometimes you can get into those bones and make them swell back.
Look at that thing, man.
It's been non-stop action.
Ray Leonard. Trigger Ray Leonard. And I forgot who that is. I can't think of the name. Durango. That's the name.
And what's happening? Duran says no.
Duran. I said Durango. My dumb ass. Duran. Roberto Durant. Where did I get Durango from?
The police are in the ring and we have a very, very unpleasant situation.
I don't understand.
The referee has not declared the fight over yet. Durant suddenly said, I quit.
I don't understand.
I don't either.
I don't understand it.
So, well, I don't understand it. That's Julio Cesar Chavez and I don't know who that one guy is. His son just got beat by Canelo Alvarez. I'm just saying.
If he gets up, he probably wins the fight.
Oh, yeah. That's like the last second. Yeah, like the last that fight, like you said, 5 seconds, he stopped the fight. And Chavez was losing that fight. Mike Tyson and Holyfield, when he bites his ear? Why he bite his ear? I never got that. Ref like, what's wrong with this guy? Holyfield's playing dramatic as hell, like, eh. He bit his ear, that's some nasty shit. Mike Tyson used to be the man, boy. I say probably most feared boxer ever.
Holyfield was outraged by that.
Yeah, he bit the fuck out of that air, boy.
And what is the referee going to do about that? 1 point deduction for Tyson. 1 point deducted for Mike Tyson for biting Holyfield's ear. Now let's take a look again.
Because it's just here. He gets into the position there. Watch.
Arr! Bit that thing.
There he bites him there. You see him lift his teeth. And Holyfield in agony at that point, trying to rip free. And an awful lot of pain.
Ugh. Well, this is, and the Tyson like, bro, why are you complaining? It's just the air. You know what I'm saying? It's just your ear. You're not going to use it.
Look at me. I got to go home. My kids are going to be scared of me. Look at me, man.
What are you going to do now in terms of your career, Mike? What are you going to do?
They're going to be scared because you got a cut above your eye? Shut that up. Oh, it tells you what's happening below. I didn't even peep that.
Oh dear, oh dear. There's only a parachute that's hit the ropes. I do not believe this clown, where he has come from. Unreal.
How you know it was an accident? Dang, people start beating up on a man? Little cheap shot.
Hit the canopy above the ring ridge.
Yeah,
his parachute is still jammed up there.
That's right, and he hit the ropes though.
Yes, he actually, his feet were actually right.
Yeah, he got underneath the canopy. Oh dear, I'm glad he didn't fall on us here, Jim, I tell you that. Well, what can we do? That's absolutely ridiculous. See, they've got to pull that parachute down because the people who've paid, I mean, up to $800 here, remember, $100 to $800, they won't be able to see the fight. But I've never seen
that thing still caught up there.
Like sentinels around the ropes here, waiting for this clown, whoever he is. I'll tell you what.
So I didn't know it wasn't an accident. They think it's on purpose. They're like, oh. He falls into the crowd. People are like, you're not. No, are you okay? No. They're like, we're going to beat you up because you ruined our fight. So you took 2 L's. Well, 3 L's. You crashed. You got beaten up. And people hate you. So, hold those L's, buddy. See the palace. Is that Las Vegas?
Paul is actually looking a little bit looser, Reggie. His defenses have loosened.
That's a not quite as tight and compact as it was. I don't know what's going on here, if he's taking a breather or what's happening here. He's going to have to tighten up and try to take charge. I wonder if already he's feeling the pace. That was a hectic round, the previous one.
Guy gets stuck between the ropes. And people drag him down and beat him up. That's crazy.
But it looked to me, Tim, as if some of the people, some of the spectators started to throw punches at him as he fell down onto the
ground.
Did
you see that?
Oh, yes, I certainly did.
Yeah.
It looked like they were really doing a job on him.
Well, he landed on the ring apron. That is an area that is occupied by skilled photographers. He was very near the bow corner, so there would be some boxing people in that corner, the handlers of Riddick Bowe. And then immediately behind him, I believe...
Dang, this long-ass part. We get it. The man crashing in the boxing ring. This number one, was it two? I think it was two.
Press seating in the few rows that are immediately behind the photographer area, which is right along the ringside itself.
Oh, man, we get it. Man, crash. Y'all gonna keep showing replay and... Yeah, we get it, yeah.
He landed literally on the top strand. Obviously, he was trying to land in the ring. He's hung up. Now he's being pulled down. And this is where, all right, now we're seeing that it would appear that the injuries came from this reaction by the people there. In fact, we see one man swinging a radio.
Yeah, we got a radio?
You can see the parachutist now, the skydiver. Slumped down from apparently a blow. We won't again speculate further on exactly how the injuries occurred.
Wow, they're really gonna take this long on this video. Okay.
Now, as we have this ongoing delay, let's go to our host, James Brown.
All right, Timmy, thank you very much. And I'm standing here with Mark Ratner.
That gotta be like the last video.
Mark, I've got to ask you this question. In all of your years, have you ever seen an occurrence like this?
Never. It's the furthest thing we would ever expect. Out of the sky, this guy, crazy man, comes down.
Finally, it was freaking number four.
A couple days prior to the fight, it had been set up that if Liston wins...
Oh, the mom of the lead, Sonny Liston.
The fight took place, and Liston takes a dive.
Sonny Liston said, all I care about is the do-re-mi. And so he was telling me then he was boxing strictly for money. It wasn't like he threw a fight. I'm just fighting for money.
I mean, to me, he just didn't fancy the fight. He knew Ali was just too fast, too quick for him. And I think he swallowed it.
Liston was scared to death of the black Muslims. He was threatened by the black Muslims. And he took a dive. Everybody knows it. I knew it. And I was quite vocal about it in the ring after. If Liston would have lost legitimately, I'd have no qualms, you know.
That's a very famous photo. And t-shirt. Decision,
Richard the Alien Grant.
So Butler's number 8 ranking is going to take a hit. Richard Grant in the mild upset. A unanimous decision.
Oh! What?
And your new commissioner, Ray Kelly, will do something very, very important for you. You want to talk about Zapp Jr.
Look at Teddy Atlas. Getting hot.
Somebody in a suspension. James Butler should never be allowed in the ring again. Absolutely.
That thing, man, jaw's broken. And he went with the one. Oh, the plastic stuff. That junk.
Is up on his own feet. Now
escort Butler out of here. And they got him. The police are right there. They're going to escort him out. Ray Kelly, the commissioner, is right behind him. He is being taken out, and he should be thrown in a paddy wagon right now.
Can't take an L, man. Boxer Dogs live on TV. Live in TV, live on TV. Ref, really? Really, ref? Really? He dies?
Dr. Schiff is coming over to look at him. Coretta's collapsed from exhaustion from that beating on the ropes. And Dr. Alexander Schiff of the commission is trying to get at him.
He dies. He's dead.
The fight has been stopped, and the winner and new champion is Emil Griffith. But we're more concerned about the condition of Benny Kid Perret than we are about the title at the moment. We're going to have an interview with the winner. The time is 2:09 of this round. We'll have an interview with Emil Griffith as sure as soon as we find out how Benny Kid Perret is.
Well, he looks to be moving. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like, comment, share, and subscribe. Probably the most shocking one was... I would guess the Sonny Liston and Muhammad Ali one, because people, you know, at that time, in that era, people expected Sonny Liston to beat Muhammad Ali. And when he just hit that dive, it was from like a jab, and it's like, you're gonna be knocked out? Wow, okay. So I'll say that one, I guess. If you like the video, hit that like, comment, share, and subscribe. It will help your boy out a lot. The original link will be down in the description below, like I said. And until next time, I will catch you guys in the next video. Peace.